They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. Here's Hurts to throw. And that nearly an interception here on his opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. Throwing is Hurts. Airing it out deep for Woods. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game, and the Giants are going to take over in great field position. They'll run for the first time with Saquon Barkley. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Now Jones. Open man, he's got him. It's Tony for a Giant touchdown. Kadarius Toney, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Giants are going to take a first quarter lead. Graham Gano on for the extra point. It's up, it's good, and the Giants have a 7-0 lead. Following the touchdown here to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here, because to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must-wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves. But a loss here, that would move them to 3-6. And if that's the case, well, that boat is going to head out to the harbor with them still on the dock.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Looking left side, and he's got a man. Brad Smith. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 44-yard line. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And he stopped immediately there. Dexter Lawrence that time in on the stop. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Hurts sets up to throw it. He's got the first down here inside the 30 and all the way down to the 25-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
On second and 11 now, Hurts. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to...
And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Dexter Lawrence. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6. Now from the 9, here's second and goal. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. A big play forthcoming. Here's 3rd and goal. Hurts. And it's caught. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense, humming here in the early going.
Barkley hit and the ball pops free. And the Eagles have recovered. Trent, he wanted to start the season with a fumble lost in both weeks 1 and 2. Now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
Here's Jones. Following the fumble recovery, he'll throw. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
A first down carry for Barkley. And he'll get nothing there. Stopped right at the line as that will wind us down to the end of this first quarter of play. Ready to roll for the second quarter from MetLife Stadium. The Giants with the football. Throwing Jones as they've got it with a 2nd and 10. Oh, wide open, complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Quite a show of arm strength right there. That was in the air for a long time, and it was on target, too. Gano for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. taken in at the three. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. He'll look to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Sanders. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. But I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They'll drop the throw. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins, his first touchdown on the year. There the Eagles are back within a score. Elliott good on the extra point, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. After the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Just the one misstep for them in the first half of the season. 7-1 is the record at the midway point. And in terms of whatever power rankings you want to go by, they're at or near the top of the list in terms of best teams in the National Football League.
And for me, in my little bit of rankings here, I've got them at the top. I know there's still 2 months to go, and we've seen teams get off to hot starts and then fade away due to injuries or the schedule or whatever. But unless there are a rash of injuries on this team, I'd be surprised if they aren't a first or a second seed come playoff time.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6. And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Off the play fake, Jones. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Second and 10. Off play action, Jones. He's going to air one out. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. A big connection on that one. 31 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10.
And they're going to go jet sweep here. This is Ross with it. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Off the play fake. Jones sliding out of the pocket. And here he'll get it down to the 7. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Operating from the gun, Jones. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A 4-yard pickup, not enough. Fourth down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Here Jones gets it out quickly, complete. A great open field tackle is going to stop him shy of the goal line. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And this Eagle defense stands tall down near the goal line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. When you're backed up this deep, sometimes defenses sacrifice coverage for pass rush because they know you can only go so far on your pass drop. You've got the back of the end zone. So they came after him. He took the shot downfield. He didn't connect, but boy, that was force.
Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Julian Love picks it. Oh, some strong running, and he'll be brought down around the 7-yard line. Well, they were obviously backed up, had a little bit of space from the goal line, snapping it from the 3, but still trying to throw it, and...
Yeah, exactly. This is where hindsight is 20/20 comes into play, right? Seems like a good idea to throw the ball there. Maybe you'll surprise them and catch them off guard. Instead, you've created a turnover and put your defense in a bad spot.
Oh, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. This will go as an 11-yard loss there on first and goal.
But that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face, not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey.
Meanwhile, Jones' throw taken in by Slayton.
And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. They'll still have a third and goal now despite picking up 13 yards on that pass play. Back to throw. Jones. And that is caught. He's got it for a giant touchdown. John Ross with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead. I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point try, good by Gannon, and it's now 21-7. Gannon now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Taking it about the 1. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go. Wide open is Watkins. He's got it. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Escaping the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
To throw once more on second and 10. Hurts. Flush to his right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back in pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. They'll look to throw again. It's caught by Sanders. And he will have a first down as they're into field goal range now at the 30. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. But first down, Hurts. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Watkins. Touchdown! Quez Watkins with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Eagles get a late score here the final minute of the first half. Elliott now to add the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. Buying time to his left. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
From the 31, Jones eluding the pressure right. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And Ingram holds it in. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Now Jones on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. A final shot before break. Jones
Going deep downfield for Ross. And this is caught. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. So we've reached halftime here at MetLife Stadium with the Giants out in front. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead, and they are set to receive this kick. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Going deep downfield for Ross. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Looking to throw. Jones gets this quickly to Ingram. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that's going to make it fourth down. And this will be a Giants first down as he'll get this up to about the 42. Backed up where they were on this side of the field, that was a gutsy call.
A gutsy call that never should have happened. Not so much them going for it. That's their decision. But where's the defensive front? Where's the leverage? Where's the low man wins? Where's getting into the offensive backfield and spilling the play? How did they permit them to pick up a first down in that situation?
To throw on second and six, Jones. That'll be caught. It's Tony. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
As I take a look at the clock, I realize that this drive has eaten up a good portion of the fourth quarter already. Gotta tell you, partner, when you're trying to salt away a game, this is exactly what it's supposed to look like.
And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Now whistles here and a flag down. I think a Giant jumped early. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Giants take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Gano the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Now their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
From the 30 on second down, Hurts. Flushed out right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Jalen Smith able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage. And
into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers.
Well, really not much secret there. Third and long, Charles, and he was looking to throw the football. And I would imagine as a defender, you're kind of salivating in that spot, right?
You certainly are, because third and long situations, they tip the scale towards the defense every single time. Now you're actually able to dictate and understand what the offense is trying to do. You know where the first down marker is. You set your defense that way. And maybe you can be a little more aggressive in certain situations because of that. You start focusing on your coverage assignment, and when the ball's released, you break on it and make a play, as we just saw there.
Now a throw here, hauled in. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. On second down, here's Barkley. And down inside the 15 he goes.
77 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
So a solid run by Saquon Barkley and another first and 10 here. Now a handoff here to his running back. And despite the fancy footwork we saw, they'll get to him just inside the 15. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Off play action. Jones. They'll roll him out right. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Daniel Jones. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the Giants are able to grow their lead. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught at the 5. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by 2 more. And that's something you almost never see nowadays. When you fake it, you're at the 15-yard line on a PAT as opposed to just going for it from the 2.
I'm sorry. I know they got it, and congratulations to them. But it's just not a good play. I mean, the risk-reward is really off the charts. Not in your favor. Run your offense out there. Put it on the 2-yard line if you want to go for 2. But I'll be darned. They ended up getting that one, didn't they?
The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there.
Azeez Ojulari.
Gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A. Another try after the first down sack. Hurts. Being chased out left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. They're going on fourth down with Hurts. Over the middle, complete. That's Watkins. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. So a moment to catch our collective breath after the fourth down conversion. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On first and 10, it's Hurts. And one more time, that's Watkins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers.
So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Oh, what a grab by Woods.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That's just his second catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. They've done a great job of doing that.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should.
And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Azeez Ojulari able to record his fifth sack of the season. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Now back to throw. And this one complete to Smith. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. They got a man over the middle. It's Woods. And the Eagles are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
And with the scoreboard against them here in the fourth quarter, this was definitely four down territory. Really nice job there finding a way to get open, and a really nice throw.
And Sanders has it poked free. And who's got it? The Giants!
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they have to be feeling pretty good. Comfortable fourth quarter lead as they take over following the fumble recovery. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Jones off the play fake, escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. They'll try and run some clock here with Barkley. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Escaping a tackle at the 25. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
122 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Now Saquon Barkley, they're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Now on second and 13. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. They push him back 8 yards that time on second down.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
And oh, that's going to wind up incomplete. Nearly their first pick of the game, but it does bring up fourth down.
They got the win last week despite not having any interceptions, trying to come up with one there, could not. But there's a stat category called PEEP.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. They're not going to get it. They try to move the chains with a surprise, but it's a turnover on downs.
The Eagles in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. From the gun, it's Hurts.
Flush to his right. Fights him off. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset.
They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Hurts throw complete there to Smith.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Forced out to his left. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Throwing again on second down, Hurts. And that's complete to Sanders. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 20-yard line. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's
touchdown, Eagles!
Devontae Smith,
his sixth touchdown of the season.
And the Eagles have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
Now that Eagle offense will stay out there as they'll go for two.
Hurts will throw.
Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a two-point conversion, but still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do, and don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he'd had hands, he'd be playing on offense.
Yeah, that's true. You've said that before. Returnable here for Davis. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And still two timeouts defensively, but even if they choose to use those, three kneel downs should be enough to get out of here with a victory.
And that's exactly what's being stated into the head coach's headset. Oftentimes they have a guy upstairs who monitors this at the end of the game. A little clock management 101.
But how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up?
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
After what they faced during this game, where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, that has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
Now it looks like he'll throw here.
And they go back to Tony. It's complete this time.
And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts.
That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Eluding the pressure right. They'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Looking to throw again on second down. Jones, he's going to look deep down the field. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Well, I know it points to this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal, that's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for the Giants, they're setting themselves up as a major contender as they move to 8-1 now on the year. And they'll get another home date next week as the 49ers will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they're going to get an extra week to stew over this as they're not back in action until week 11.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a twin. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real.
fire to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling.
Don't feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling.
Hey, Belly. Them ready?
Yeah. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just
how I'm feeling.